to my channel. Today I want to talk about tortoises and turtles and how they show affection. So I recently came across an article that I found very interesting about how turtles and tortoises show affection and whether they bond to their owner or their caregiver. So of course the way a tortoise or a turtle may show affection is going to be a lot different from how a dog, a cat, or another mammal or a bird would show affection to their owner. And I feel that this is already a question in whether our dogs or our cats, can they love us? Are they capable of these feelings that some people think only humans are capable of? And I of course think that yes, they are, and I don't see why a tortoise or a turtle cannot be capable. I also think that even though they are capable of these feelings and these emotions and bonding, and they're not only looking to their people for food or safety or security, they're also looking to people for emotion and comfort and love. It will of course vary between species, and how we humans express and feel is going to be different from how mammals and reptiles and birds, how they express and feel. But I do think they are capable of these things, maybe just not at the same level or to the same extent, but that doesn't make them any less worthy or less capable or less anything. It just makes them different. Different does not mean worse. It doesn't mean we're better or we can feel more. It's just in a different way, in a different form. It's just different. So this article spoke about how turtles and tortoises use their body language, use scent and sound to show what they are calling love and affection. And basically what it all comes down to is if the tortoise or turtle feels safe and they are going about their normal, regular routine that is normal for a turtle or tortoise, then they are showing affection and they're showing love. And if they're not always hiding or in a fearful state, if they're out in the open, if they're basking and walking around and being comfortable with who they are and in their environment, then they are showing love. So if they're just able to sit and be content in your presence, that's them showing their affection to you. They're not really gonna come up and cuddle you or want to sit on you, or like a cat do the kneading, or like a dog, they're going to just be comfortable in your presence. And turtles and tortoises also will be really curious about what you're doing. They'll want to check out what you're doing. They're really interested in what you're doing. This is them showing that they see you, they notice you, they recognize you, and they appreciate you. It's also been noted that if a turtle or tortoise will stretch out their neck really long, they're often asking for a scratch or a rub on their neck. Now, I haven't done this with my turtles. I do not currently have a tortoise. I have 3 turtles. And I am on a wait list for a tortoise, and I'm so excited. I've been on that wait list for seriously like 5 years, and it's coming soon, it's coming soon. And turtles and tortoises do get excited when their human or their caretaker enters the room, which I definitely notice with my turtles. I always thought that they were just excited to get food or they wanted food, but sometimes if I give them food and they're not even really hungry, they're still just excited to see me. They do get excited when I walk into the room and when I pay them attention. And a common behavior of tortoises in the wild is to kind of bump you or bump other tortoises with their nose when they want attention. And tortoises do this with people, with their caregivers, when they want attention. And often this attention is just for a scratch on the neck or just to say hi. So when they touch you with their nose, this is a social behavior, and they do this with humans, so this is their way of showing affection to their humans. It has also been reported that tortoises will follow their humans around the house, so again, this is just being content and enjoying the company of their caregivers. Turtles and tortoises also show curiosity and boredom, which I definitely notice in my turtles whenever I do something different in their enclosure, change something up, or add something, take something out, or just whenever I'm working, changing the water or cleaning the filters, they're always watching and they're really curious and they want to know what I'm doing. And then when I leave, they always go check out, or when I'm finished doing whatever I was doing, they always swim over or walk over and check out what I had done, and they look at what's new and what's different. And I've actually noticed my dart frogs do this, and so do my geckos. So I feel like they all show curiosity and they show boredom, because maybe this is something exciting. It's something new. Everyone's excited about something new. And bored turtles and tortoises will often display destructive behaviors. So they'll flip over their food bowl or their water dish, and they'll cause a mess in their enclosure, tear plants apart. If your turtle or tortoise does this, you can take them out and let them explore, or add some enrichment or some toys or something in their enclosure to give them something to look at or to think about, something to do. So what does a happy turtle or tortoise look like? So this is a turtle or tortoise that will just be content to sit in one spot. They maybe stretch their neck out, stretch their arms and legs out, and just bask out in the open and just be completely relaxed and content. And if they're hiding, this probably means that they are a little fearful, a little anxious, maybe scared or just not feeling that well. Of course, it's normal to retreat. Sometimes you want to look at kind of the overall behavior, what they're doing more often than not. Turtles and tortoises can also recognize their caretakers or their owners, or they notice the difference between other people, which I definitely agree. I've always known that my turtles can tell me from other people and anyone else that enters the room. Often I'll enter the room and my turtle will just be sitting out basking, and if someone else enters the room that they're not used to, the turtle will crash and dive into the water and make a big fuss about hiding and getting away, because this is someone that they don't trust yet, that they don't know yet. And they can tell the difference between the two people, me and someone else that they're not that familiar with. A lot of the time, they definitely do associate me with food, and that's probably definitely a big part about them trusting me and being excited around me and wanting to see me, but that doesn't mean that they have to be super content to be around me. Overall, it's not really clear if tortoises or turtles can bond with their owners, but I definitely do think that they at least enjoy our presence. Maybe it's because we provide food, but I think there's a little bit more to it. If you have a turtle or tortoise, let me know in the comments what you think. If you think your turtle or tortoise has bonded to you, can bond to you, how they show affection to you. I'm sure that there's a lot of stories about how they show affection or ask for attention or scratches or even a brush of the shell. Turtles and tortoises are very intelligent animals, so it's definitely not hard to think that they are capable of forming these bonds and this relationship and feeling these emotions. enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.